over the years with Johnny Wilkinson. There the Irish coach Warren Gatland, who played 140 games for Waikato, looking suitably pleased with the situation. 11-3, good cushion. Wilkinson again hoisted miles up in the air. Galway did well to get hands to it. Humphreys, and there again a big kick. Balshaw took it well. That's a massive Gary Owen, and they've got to communicate. Was eventually taken by Girvan Dempsey, and quite right, the man coming forward should always take it. Ball stolen there by Galway. Stringer with the nice little left footer. Wilkinson. It's a real ping pong bit, this, isn't it? Girvan Dempsey waits. He can run. So can that big fella, Eric Miller. Just inside Irish territory. Good chance there. Is fed out to O'Driscoll. And Horgan goes. Horgan's a big guy. 6'3", 15 and a half stones. They're 15 metres inside England's half. But England with a chance to counter as Wilkinson feeds out. Dawson with the kick. Dempsey back. Yes, he ran into the mincing machine there, all right, but and have won it again, and a lovely long kick by Humphreys, and well, it was such an awkward one for Balshaw, I must say. I felt for him there. His own kick isn't such a bad one, but Hickey has got across. This is an amazing passage of play, I tell you. They'll be glad to hear the whistle for something. Here's another chance for Mike Catt. He's kicked it up the middle of the field. Stringer feeds out to Dempsey. Dempsey thumps it. There'll be a great cheer if he finds touch.
Well, I think that bit of aerial ping-pong was decided in Ireland's favour, and I think that's also indicative of the difference in the team's tactical planning, because I think Ireland's kicking game has been far more effective than England's.